Welcome again to the Food Biotechnology course. In this part, I will talk about whole organisms, whole microorganisms that we eat as food, because in the earlier presentations you heard about products of microorganisms that we consume or transformations of foods by enzymes. But this time we will eat the whole microorganisms that are produced. And a very typical microorganism that is produced are the mushrooms. And the mushrooms, of course, they can be collected in the wild or they can be produced in closed environment, in controlled environment. The problem with collecting mushrooms in the forest is the limited availability, and more the production of the mushrooms in closed facilities becomes popular because the quality is good and the availability of the mushrooms is also very good. So the mushrooms, just by definition, the mushrooms are the fruiting bodies of macroscopic edible fungi, and they have been part of the human diet since more or less ever. And they can be rich in protein, so the protein content can be 20 to 40%, for example, in agaricus, in the bottom mushroom. The vitamin B concentration can be high, and also the vitamin C concentration can be high, and this is important for nutrition. We also have a precursor of vitamin T, which is present in the mushrooms, which is a specific metabolite of fungi in general. So this can also be regarded as a source of vitamin D, but in combination with the exposure to sunlight. So the wild mushrooms, or also the cultivated mushrooms, they grow on decomposing matter from the forest, so they can digest polymeric carbohydrates like cellulose, and they also can digest lignin, depending on the type of mushroom that we consider. The mostly produced mushroom is the Agaricus bisporus. This is the white mushroom, and the interesting point for production is that this mushroom doesn't need light for formation of the fruiting bodies. Other mushrooms that are cultivated, they need light to induce the fruiting body formation, and this is, for example, the shiitake mushroom, the winter mushroom, or the Chinese straw mushroom and oyster mushroom. So they all need light for fruiting body formation. The growth of the mycelium can be done in the dark, and when the mycelium is exposed to light, the fruiting body formation starts. This light is not necessary for the production of the bottom mushroom. The bottom mushroom is very popular, so it accounts to more or less 60% of the total productivity of mushrooms in the world. And the second one, which is cultivated, the second biggest one, which is cultivated, is the shiitake mushroom and straw and oyster mushroom. But it mainly depends on the climate and the temperature, because mushrooms are low-cost food, so the production should also be a low-cost production. If climatization is needed, this increases the cost of the production facility. When we look at the flow diagram of the production of the Agaricus bisporus, we see that we have two different starting points. And one of the starting points is the nutrition for the fungi, which is the compost, which is produced from straw, from wheat straw, and also from horse manure. With this mixture, a hot rotting is done, so the composting process is at higher temperatures. And after this composting, the pasteurization is done at 60 degrees centigrade for a prolonged period. The second important step is the germination of the spores, which is the inoculum. And these germinated spores are then mixed with the pasteurized compost and inoculated, and the growth of the mycelium starts at the temperature is around 25 degrees centigrade, and this takes 2 to 3 weeks that the density of the mycelium on this raw material is high enough that this can be put into cases and then transferred to the production room where the temperature is significantly lower. So we have around 14 to 18 degrees, still in the dark, so light is not needed. And there it is kept for around 11 days. And in this period, the fruiting body formation starts. So the harvesting is then done and it can be repeated, repeated periods of harvesting. So every week for a prolonged period, for several weeks, every week the mushrooms can be harvested. The residual compost, which is around 50% of the raw material, because 50% are decomposed by the fungi, so the residual compost has to be pasteurized and it can be used for fertilizing any agricultural area. Yes, they are, let's say, the nutrients that the Agaricus bisporus needs. This is derived from the lignin, from the cellulose and from the hemicellulose, which is present in the straw and also in the horse manure. The protein and the nitrogen that the fungi needs is mainly of bacterial origin. So the bacteria that grow during the composting process, they are also the protein and the nitrogen source for the mushroom. Composting takes around 2 weeks. And then if it is adequately prepared, it can be used for the growth of the mushroom. However, it has to be taken into mind that bacteria growing at medium temperatures, like mesophilic bacteria, they can take over the growth and destroy the productivity of the bottom mushroom. The rotting process of the compost is done at higher temperatures, so in average 60 to 70 degrees. The heap of the compost has to be turned over to remove a little bit the heat and to get oxygen into this compost. So after 8 to 9 days, the composting is finished, it is packed and can be pasteurized. The pasteurization is necessary because not all the compost is exposed to these high temperatures, especially on the outside, on the surface. The temperature is more or less ambient temperature, so pasteurization is necessary to remove the bacteria and to remove also insects which are living in this compost. The compost after pasteurization is cooled down to 25 degrees and inoculated with spores or with germinated spores, which is around up to 1% of the total volume is the inoculum, and then it is incubated at, as is mentioned here, at 17 degrees. Yeah, the first harvest starts after 3 weeks. This is the first crop, and after several periods where we have intervals of 1, 2, 3 weeks, depending on the type of harvest, the harvest is repeated. And as you see here, the yield is about up to one kilogram of mushrooms per 1 kilogram of compost. So this is fresh weight of mushrooms per fresh weight of compost. Meaning that when we calculate in area, that up to 30 kilograms of mushrooms can be harvested per square meter of cultivation area. Yeah, and the compost is degraded to about 50%, which can be used further as a fertilizer. So we have the bottom mushroom, and the other one, which is also a big volume production, is the shiitake mushroom, which originally grows in the forest, so on specific trees, and these specific trees can be taken, like, let's say, the beech, chestnut, oak trees, and originally the shi tree. They can be inoculated by drilling holes into the logs, adding the mycelium or the spores, closing it and leaving it for around 1 year in this so-called laying yard, and there the mycelium can develop. And after this, after about 1 year, the mushrooms start developing from these wooden logs. It is also possible that the wood is not used as a whole log of a tree. It can be used as sawdust mixed with rice bran, because we need some kind of nitrogen protein source, and then we have the necessary water content of up to 65% humidity, and in this environment the shiitake mushroom can grow. So this mushroom can also be used not only as a mushroom but also for seasoning, because it has a very specific property as taste enhancer, which can be used for spicing of foods. So thank you for your attention. This time I was talking about microorganisms that we could eat as a whole for food, and in this specific case I was talking about mushrooms. Thank you for your attention.